robots are fantastic because they can do all the things that are too dull and dirty and dangerous for people to do. But they're also really hard to make, especially if they have to work outside in unpredictable environments, right? Even the smallest error can lead to the demise of the entire robot. And so what we do in my lab is we try to build robot collectives. So many simple, inexpensive robots that together can do much more than the single robot could. And now we have a system where a lot of robots can work in parallel. We have a system where if many robots fail, that's okay because the rest can still complete whatever task we've given them. So that brings a lot of challenges with it. There are challenges in hardware. How do I make simple, inexpensive robots that are still capable of doing what I want them to do? It brings challenges in algorithms. So how do I coordinate many robots, right? I want to coordinate a lot of them. I also want these algorithms to be tolerant to failures of individuals. And those kinds of algorithms are not very intuitive for people to design. Fortunately, we have great proof of concept because social insects in nature do this all the time, right? And they do it very successfully. So a colony of honeybees, for instance, are able to forage, they're able to do nest care, defense, maintenance, nursing, all of these things that are very complex, and they're able to do it in a very efficient manner without any central point of intelligence telling them all what to do. So part of what we do in my lab is we develop new technology with which to look at the social insects and study them, and then what we learn from them will help us improve our own robot designs and our own algorithms. And then we also tend to blur the line a little bit, so we actually mix up the two worlds. We try to create artificial systems that can give incentives to the insects so that they will do what we want them to do. So a good example there is a new system we're working on that will help honeybees pollinate sort of at the farmer's intuition.